Let us see our next question. On 1st of July 2018, Mr. X, during initial public offer of a mutual fund, invested rupees 1 lakh at the face value of rupees 10. So 1 lakh rupees investment, face value is 10, and that is the purchase price also. So 10,000 number of units must have been allotted. On 31st of March 2019, mutual fund declared a dividend of 10%. So we understand that, so the 10,000 number of units into 10, that comes to 1 lakh rupees the face value into 10%, 10,000 is the dividend amount. When Mr. X calculated that, his holding period return was 115%. On 31st of March 20, mutual fund again declared a dividend at the rate of 20%. On 31st of March 2021, Mr. X redeemed all his balance, that is investment, which had accumulated to 11,296.11 units when his holding period return was 202.17%. Calculate NAV on 31st of March 19, 31st of March 20 and 31st of March 21. These are the three dates on which we are required to find NAV. Again friends, you can definitely understand that say 1 lakh divided by 10, initially 10,000 number of units were allotted, and at the time of final redemption, the number of units held by the investor is 11,296.11. In between, you have been provided with the dividend information. So of course, it has been provided to us indirectly that say the investment is made in dividend reinvestment plan. Accordingly, we are required to make the calculation of answer. So please write an answer along with me. Assuming that investment is made in dividend reinvestment plan, comma, we are finding net asset value. Read on heading calculation of net asset value as on 31st of March 2019. So I request all of you to make the calculation of this answer and put your answer in the chat box. Let us see that say how to calculate the answer. I request all of you to write an answer along with me. Working note number 1. Calculation of units allotted on 1st of July 2018. It is investment divided by NAV per unit. What is the amount of investment? 1 lakh rupee. What is NAV per unit? 10 rupees per unit. That comes to 10,000 units. That is the way we are required to make the computation of the units allotted to the investor initially. Working note number 2. Calculation of dividend income on 31st of March 2019. Of course, it is reinvested. It is face value of investment into date of dividend. So 10,000 into 10, that comes to 1 lakh.
into 10%, that comes to an amount of rupees 10,000. Next, I am doing it only by one method now, the method which I recommend to all of you. Assuming that
NAV per unit is rupees X, comma, answer is found. We understand that the holding period of return is equal to income upon investment in 200. What is the holding period return? It is 115%. The income is 10,000 rupees is the dividend divided by NAV X rupees per unit. So this is the number of units allotted plus 10,000 initial units allotted. Whole into X minus the investment made 1 lakh, whole divided by 1 lakh into 100. That is the way X is supposed to be calculated. You may think that, sir, you have forgotten the time period. No, this time I have not forgotten. Number of times I commit mistake, I agree with that. But this time you can see that the question is providing the information that holding period return was 115%, not the annualized return. If it is annualized return, you have to do 12 divided by n. In case of the holding period return, you don't have to consider the time period. Whatever this time period for which you have kept the investment, for that the return is provided to us as 115%. This is the way we are required to make the calculation of answer. So here it is 115 into 1 lakh divided by 100 is equal to 10,000 divided by X into X, that is 10,000 plus 10,000 into X is 10,000X minus 1 lakh. Okay. So 10,000X will be found as balancing figure. It is over here 1,15,000. Plus 1 lakh minus 10,000. So 1,15,000 plus 1 lakh minus 10,000, 2,05,000. Divided by 10,000 units, that is 20 rupees 50 paise. This is the way we can compute the NAV per unit on the date on which, say, the return is calculated, 31st of March 2019. So preparing a small summary of the working, that is the information. Column number 1 is date 1st of July 2018. The amount of investment is 1 lakh. Net asset value per unit is 10. Number of units allotted to the investor it is 10,000, that is 1 lakh upon 10. balance units, it is again 10,000. Then rate of dividend. In that nothing, and holding period of return, in that nothing initially. Then 31st of March 2019, 10,000 number of units into 10, this is the face value, into rate of dividend is 10%, that comes to 10,000 rupees. As per the recent calculation that we have made, net asset value is 20 rupees 50 paise. So the units that will be allotted is 10,000 upon 20.5. So the answer comes to 487.80. So the balance increases to 10,487.80. And the rate of dividend is 10%. And holding period return is 115%. Now friends, honestly, something like this happens to us with us in examination also. Like when we are in a hurry of giving answer, because we see a similar question that we already have done from the practice manual, from study material, from past examination paper, we go with the routine process. And we tend to forget that say, this holding period return is provided to us in the question. And of course, in that case, say, you will be losing the entire marks. This is holding period return. This is what we understand. Now, I want you to make the computation of the answer, that what will be the NAV per unit on 31st of March 2020. I request you to take down this table. Now friends, on 31st of March 2020, the information is given that say, again 20% dividend was given. You can see that say, neither information is provided to us about the return, nor any other information is given. So again we are stuck up. But now we know that say, we are required to take into account that what is the number of units that have been redeemed on 31st of March 2021. It has been given that it is 11,296.11. This is the number of units so that have been redeemed on 31st of March 2021. Okay. So, this is the number of units that you would be having on this date. And accordingly, we are required to make the calculation of answer. So, write down heading calculation of net asset value per unit on 31st of March 2020. It is amount of dividend divided by number of units. Amount of dividend is 10,487.80 into 10, that is the face value of the investment, into 20%, that is the amount of dividend, divided by units is 11,296.11 minus 10,487.80. So 20,975.6 divided by 11,296.11 minus 10487.8, so 808.31. So the NAV per unit is 25.95. Rupees per unit. This is the way the NAV per unit can be calculated. So over here, the amount of the dividend is 20975.60. This is 25.95, and this is 808.31. Now, lastly, it has been given. Let's say you have been able to get the return of 202.17%. Once again, I request all of you to make the calculation of this NAV per unit and put your answer in the chat box. So this answer is also very simple. Read on heading, calculation of NAV per unit on 31st of March 2021. The answer would be calculated like this. Return is equal to income upon investment into 100. The return is given to us, not 12 divided by n. Okay, 202.17. Importantly, it is 11,296.11 number of units into x minus the investment was made 1 lakh. Divided by again investment 1 lakh into 100 for getting answer in percentage term. Using the initial investment, we are required to make the calculation of answer. So it's very simple. 202.17 into 1 lakh divided by 100 is equal to 11,296.11x. minus 1 lakh. Okay. So 11,296.11x is equal to, this answer is 202,170. 2,2170 plus 1 lakh. So 3,2170 upon 11,296.11. That is 26.75. This is the way NAV per unit is supposed to be calculated. So over here it is 26.75. No dividend was given. No number of units. The return information is given to us for holding period 202.17%.